Hi, welcome back to one more collection overview video. Today we are talking about the Caveco Artsport, the second generation. And the second generation of this band was composed by eight bands. I only have seven of them, and they were very nice pens made of acrylics, like the first generation that you have here. I already posted a video about them, and they share some characteristics. So, what do I know about these? I know that there were made eight pens. I know that some of those pens had mechanical pencil variation with the same material. I don't know exactly which because I don't focus that much on these Caveco pencils. Maybe someday, but not for now. We'll just talk about the fountain pens. We know that there were eight made of acrylics. They were produced somewhere between 2009 and 2013. These ones. The biggest difference between these ones and these was those were only available with steel nibs, noble nibs. They could be steel with original color or gold-plated nibs, but just steel nibs. There was another difference. There was no brass weight inside the barrel to give some more weight to the pen. So let's check them out. This is not a review. I will not make any writing sample about these. Sometime I'll make a review of some of them, but today just to see how these pens are. So first of all, we have this one. First of all, I don't mean this was the first to be released. I don't have that information, but I know this one is a It is the first that I'm choosing now. This variation is the amethyst, which is this marbled purple color. It is very nice. It has a chrome trim. It has no knurled end like you can find in the Ice Sport range, as you can see. And it has this nice collar that runs all through the cap, the barrel, and the section. The nib is a regular nib, steel and natural collar nib. This one has a modern feed and nib. Nothing more about it, except a little detail. In the cap, as in the first generation, they say Caveco Artsport, but this one says Germany also. Then we have the lapis. The lapis is a blue pen. It has a very nice color. It is very sought of, and this one can still be found. This one is very hard to find now. This one is easily found today. It has gold trim. Interesting part, it says Caveco Artsport, no Germany here. Then it has a gold-plated nib. And that's it. I'll put the pens open here so it's nicer to see them. As I said, or if I didn't, I shall say now, these pens are made of acrylic, so they are a little heavier than the plastic ones, and they have a nicer feel to it. This one is the Axeir. Which has this kind of interesting pattern, although this doesn't look like any natural pattern like those. But it is nice. This is the, it says there Caveco Artsport, and sometimes some of those can buy on eBay or at some web stores, mainly Spanish web stores, and this has a silver collar trim, and Nothing more about it. Then we'll go to the next one, which is the granite. The granite, it tries to imitate the stone, the granite. It is very nice, the feel. It really looks like stone, but it is acrylic as the other ones. I wouldn't just put these regular intervals of darker, like darker rings. I think that looks a little bit unnatural. This one has gold trim, and on the cap it says Caveco Heart Sport, no Germany. Also, the nib is also a regular gold plated nib, a modern one, and this one is an EF nib. Then one of the nicest in my opinion, because this looks like taken out of a snow storm, or if you want, it really looks like marble. It's a very beautiful pen. It looks darker here because it has an ink cartridge inside. If I take the cartridge, it will be much more transparent, and it is a very, very, very nice finish. I think this is one of the nicest finishes of the second generation. It has a gold-plated nib, and not much more to say about it, with golden trim here also. And on the cap, it says Caveco Art Sport Germany. So maybe with this information we may find like two sub-series of the or two series from the second generation, but I have no way to confirm this. Then we go to the Rosette pen. This is the less interesting in my opinion, because I don't love red, but that's not the problem. It's because the chatoyancy or the color variation is not very apparent. It has silver color trim, and here it has something strange. Unlike all the others, this one has a silver filled imprint on the cap saying Caveco Art Sport with no Germany also, but this is the one that has this filled with color. And here we have a steel nib and nothing more to it. This one can still be found. So the Axe here, I'll talk about their availability later. Then the other one that I find the most interesting, for me the most interesting ones are these, the blues from the first generation, the alabaster, and then this is the amacitrine. And the amacitrine is a yellow color, marble yellow color. It's very similar to this pen, to the amethyst, but in yellow. It has silver color trim, and it says on the cap Caveco Quartz Sport Germany. This one says Germany. And here we have it, very common pen with an F nib, a steel nib, and nothing more to it. Cool. So about their availability, the first generation Caveco Sport, they almost can't be found. This one is very sought after. I think violet is a color that everybody wants, and it's very hard to find. I was lucky enough to find when they were still on stock, but now you can't find them. This one is quite common. You can find it for a very nice price. The Axe here, sometimes it comes up on eBay on online stores, but it's not that easy. You have to be looking for it very continuously, and sometimes one appears. This one, granite, is widely available, has the alabaster is quite available also. The rosette can still be found sometimes. It's not always on stock like these three, but It is a little bit more common than the Haxair. And then, finally, we have the Mesitrine that is quite common. So, if you want to start collecting Caveco Art Sports, my advice would be search first for the lapis, the granite, the alabaster, and the Mesitrine because they are the most easy to find and they have the best prices. They are sold about 100 euros, it's about that their price. So, this is the second generation. There is one missing here that I would love to have, but I don't have, which is the amber. The amber version is a brown pen, very different to the from the Mambo. That you have here, and it has the same color as the special edition Caveco Dia 2. So, if you have seen that special, that limited edition Caveco Dia set, it has a ballpoint and also fountain pen, it is the same color. Very nice, quite beautiful, but I can't find. I just found one for sale and it was at the time I couldn't afford it, but it was not on any online shop. It was a collector that was wanting to sell his pen. So the amber is the most difficult to find, and this one is also very difficult to find nowadays. So these two, the amber and the amethyst, are the two more hard to find. So this was the overview of Caveco Art Sport. I hope this information was useful. Some information was taken from Caveco old catalogs to try to date the pens. If you have any more information, please share with us. If you know why some of them say Germany and the other ones don't, please let us know. And ask questions, leave comments, do whatever you want, and I hope this was useful. If you find it useful, please subscribe our YouTube channel and keep watching the videos we will post on the future. I like to have you here, and I hope to have you here on the future also. See you next time. Bye.